आइए What attracts you to the civil service?
Sir, the nature of the job provides me a lot of exposure and to work at various levels, a lot of challenges as well as the opportunities in the service.
I see. And what qualities do you possess which will make you a good civil servant?
Sir, firstly, honesty and integrity.
Yeah.
Then I have a positive attitude towards life. Then I have a problem-solving approach. Also, sir, I have capability to handle the pressure situations very well. And these are some of the qualities which would be desirable in the service.
For your first attempt?
Sir, this is my third attempt.
Third attempt? Okay. Interview?
Second interview.
Second. Last time, how much did you get?
Sir, I got 138 points.
130. Okay, Mr. Dilip, can you tell me what is happening in the UK on the Brexit issue?
Sir, presently there is a deadlock in the UK Parliament over the deal which has been finalised by the Prime Minister Theresa May. And there is issue over the Irish backstop which is there. Then would it be a hard Brexit or a soft Brexit? This is another issue. So there is not emerging any consensus in the Parliament itself.
But the May's new proposal is to come up for voting now, isn't it? The next week or so?
Yes, sir.
When is Brexit due to be kicked in?
Sir, 29 March.
March.
Yes, sir.
Is there a possibility that they may extend the date also?
Sir, there may be a possibility, but currently it is 29 March.
Yeah, but they're talking about it, that they may either, the options are either, if the her proposal is not accepted,
yes,
then there are only two options. Either they request the EU for extension of the period, or they leave without any kind of an agreement.
Yes,
I mean, both those options are being looked at, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, you know the Kulbushan Jadhav's case.
Yes, sir.
Recently, we had a hearing in the ICJ. What happened in that?
Sir, in that, India put its case very strongly because many a times consular access were denied and the norms of the United Nations law were also violated by Pakistan. And also, sir, India has maintained that Kulbushan Jadhav was an Indian citizen on Indian passport in Iran, from where he was captured by Pakistan, and he has been.
So has this ICJ taken any decision?
Sir, it has not taken any decision, but both India and Pakistan have made their submissions, and now we can expect.
Submissions are over, and the ICJ will come to a decision.
Yes, sir.
Now the ICJ very recently gave another judgment relating to Mauritius. Did you read about that? About the Chagos Islands?
Sir, I know the dispute, but I am not aware of the judgment.
What dispute are you aware of?
Sir, there is a dispute over the territory, whether it belongs to England or Mauritius itself.
Correct. Right. So they have given a decision on that.
Thank you.
Okay. Now let's come to India. After the Pulwama incident, the government, the Jaish e Mohammed had claimed responsibility. What can you tell me about this terror organization, Jaish e Mohammed?
Sir, Jaish e Mohammed was formed after the release of Masood Azhar in the IC-814 hijack case. And he formed this terrorist organization basically for the purpose of snatching away Jammu and Kashmir as a part of India and to integrate it with Pakistan.
Okay.
So this is its stated purpose, and from there onwards, now it has been 2 decades, it has been perpetrating terrorists into Jammu and Kashmir with the help of the Pakistani army and the ISR.
So has the Jaish e Mohammed been active in the hinterland also?
I'm sorry, sir.
Which means outside of Jammu and Kashmir. Have they been active in any other parts of India other than J&K?
Yes, sir. They have played a role in other parts of the country also.
Which terror attacks were attributed to them?
For example, in 2611 terror attacks in Mumbai.
That was not Jaish e Mohammed. That was Lashkar attack. What about the Parliament attack?
Parliament attack.
Yeah, that was Jaish e Mohammed.
Yes, yes.
And who was hanged in that case?
Absolutely.
Yeah. And then in Pathankot, January 2016.
Yes.
What happened there?
So there are also some of the trained militants.
Yeah, they attacked. What was the target?
Military installation.
The Air Force Base. Pathankot Air Force Base was attacked by the Jaish e Mohammed.
Yes.
Right? Now, the government has decided to withdraw security to the separatists. Who are the separatists?
Sir, separatists are a group of organizations functioning in Jammu and Kashmir who are having a narrative to side with the Pakistani establishment. They want Jammu and Kashmir to be a part of Pakistan. And the government has taken this stern measure in the wake of the Pulwama attack, that why do we need to provide them security when they are promoting separatism?
Quite right. Do they have a name, the separatists?
Yes, sir.
They have an umbrella organization. What is it called?
Sir, it is known as the Huriyat Conference.
Huriyat Conference.
Yes.
Who are the prominent members of this? Any idea?
Some of the members I can name, sir.
Yeah.
Sayyid Gilani.
Yeah. Sayyid Gilani is there, sir. Very much.
Meerwais Umar Farooq. And
Yasin Malik. Yes, right. Okay. Now, the government has also very recently banned a political party in the valley.
Is it
which party is it?
Sir, the party is known by the name of Jamaat-e-Islami.
Jamaat-e-Islami, yes. Right. Thank you.
What do you mean by this term, heartfulness meditation?
Sir, heartfulness meditation is a form of meditation in which we meditate on our heart and we feel the presence of divine light inside our heart which is growing. So, hence the name heartfulness meditation.
So, nothing like mindfulness meditation?
Sir, it is a different form, yes.
And this is propagated by Sri Ramachandra Mission.
Yes.
It's different than Sri Ramakrishna Mission.
Yes, sir. It is.
How are they different?
Sir, Sri Ramakrishna Mission has been founded by Swami Vivekananda in the memory of his guru, Sri Ramakrishna Paramahansa. And at the same time, Sri Ramachandra Mission was formed by Sri Babaji Maharaj in 1945. And the basic purpose of having this organization was to promote spiritual meditation across the country as well as world. And the basic methodology which was being promoted was yogic through meditation through yogic transmission, which means that a person gives a setting to another person to transmit what we call as pranahuti into another person. So this is the methodology which we call.
So you are a regular practitioner?
Yes, sir. I'm
you do about half an hour, 45 minutes of meditation every day.
Sir, there are three things we do in an entire day. Morning meditation, then we have an evening cleaning of half an hour, and then we have a night prayer before we go to bed.
What is evening cleaning?
Sir, cleaning is a process in which we tend to remove the past impressions which we have formed inside our heart. For example, if we have some argument with anyone, or we have some problem with some other person, we have feelings like hate, fear, anger, etc. So all these impressions are removed by the process of cleaning.
So you don't allow any sanskar to be formed.
Yes, sir.
So that's very good. Okay, now you are from Rajasthan, so obviously you are always in state of bliss. But what do you identify as the major problems of the state of Rajasthan?
Sir, some of the major problems of Rajasthan are we are facing water resources problem, water scarcity. Secondly, we have some social issues like child marriage, dowry, parda system in Rajasthan. Thirdly, sir, the problem of agriculture has grown to a great extent due to the adverse impact of climate change. Crop failures have been more often. Then, sir, Rajasthan has a connectivity problem. Since being a very large state, the connectivity between the rural areas and the urban centers is a bit of a problem. Then, sir, now we are seeing a problem of growing pollution in cities like Jodhpur, Jaipur. Jodhpur was recently among the
top 20. Suppose you become the district magistrate of Pali,
yes.
How will you handle this water crisis? If there is a crisis, Pali has some water problems.
Yes, sir, it has. Okay.
How will you handle it? What are the steps you will take?
Sir, first step of mine would be water conservation, because water conservation is water produced. And I would encourage people for rainwater harvesting. Then traditional harvesting systems like Johars, Khadins, Bowries, etc. can be revived. Secondly, sir, we have a project going on in the Indira Gandhi Canal. A link is being facilitated towards Pali district. Also, sir, we can go for river rejuvenation. Pali has a major name, river named as Luni and West, as well as Jawai. These can be rejuvenated through Indira Gandhi Canal. And some of these measures can be taken, sir.
Nothing on drip and sprinkler irrigation?
Yes, sir. I forgot to mention this. As far as agriculture is concerned, these technologies can be promoted by the government by providing effective subsidies as well as terminology to master.
And changing crop pattern, not take up high value crops which take lot of water.
Yes, sir. This is another mission which we
so all the things you have to do.
Yes,
sir. And what do you do for drinking water problems if there is any? What does Rajasthan do to tackle the drinking water problems?
So the drinking water problem is tackled by in many areas by many ways. First of all, we are linking cities with the Indira Gandhi Canal. The western Rajasthan is facing a drinking water problem that is being facilitated. Secondly, water harvesting has been promoted, and through these water harvesting, the water is being purified to facilitate drinking water. And these are some of the measures being taken by the government.
Water rationing, are you still following that? Rationing of water supply?
Yes, sir, we are following that. We have water meters, and it is ensured that people conserve water. We have some high water tariffs which prohibit people from misuse of water or overuse of water.
Rajasthan is also very famous for tourism development.
Yes.
Do you think that is going to be one area which will draw your attention?
Yes, sir, definitely. Tourism has a lot of potential in Rajasthan, especially if we see at the numbers. Rajasthan attracts over 50 million domestic tourists in a year and 1.6 million foreign tourists to Rajasthan.
But mostly to three places, right?
Yes, sir, it is centered around some of the prominent places like Jaipur, Udaipur, Jodhpur. But sir, now with the growing awareness, many of the innovative models are coming up. For example, we have a village tourism concept known as Toki Dhani in Jaipur. Then eco-tourism in Ranthambore Tiger Reserve as well as Sariska Tiger Reserve is coming up. So there is a lot of potential which needs to be done.
Anything that can be done in your district?
Yes, sir, in Jodhpur also we can go for, we have already have the
Jodhpur,
tradition.
You are?
Yes.
Jodhpur district.
I belong to
you. Yeah, it's right. Okay, one last question for you. When you deal with internal security matters in the country, what do you think are the major challenges that the country faces?
Sir, as far as internal security is concerned, the country faces some of the challenges like Naxalism is an issue. Then we have the issue of separatism in Jammu and Kashmir. Terrorism is another issue gripping our country. Then in the northeastern sector, we have insurgency problems and also people moving towards secessionism there. Then we have problems like drug trafficking, human trafficking, and these are some of the problems which I can impose.
Mixed out is the most important part. Based on religion, communalism?
Yes, sir. That is indeed a very major problem in our country.
Do you think the government has been doing enough to contain the Naxal menace?
Sir, I believe that the government
tell us what have they done?
Sir, the government has followed a two-pronged strategy here. First, they have upped the military response to the Naxalists. We have the Samadhan Doctrine of the Ministry of Home Affairs, which deals with this Naxalism menace very strongly. Then we have some developmental efforts also coming up in the Naxal areas. We are connecting them through the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana.
So it's containment and development?
Yes, sir. Two-pronged.
In localized pockets,
yes.
Where there is a preponderance.
Yes, okay. Thank you, sir.
Continuing with Rajasthan, you have a bird sanctuary, National Bird Sanctuary in Bharatpur.
Yes.
What's it called?
Ma'am, it is known by the name of Kailas of Ghana National Park.
Okay. Now, here I read an article saying that lots of stray cattle have been put into this sanctuary. So, won't it affect the birds there?
Ma'am, it will indeed affect the birds there.
So what can be done about this menace of cattle, stray cattle?
Ma'am, we can follow a couple of approaches. Mm-hmm. One is to create more cow shelters for taking care of these stray cattle. Mm-hmm. Then another area where we can work is to employ many people who are unemployed in that area to catch these stray cattle and bring to the cow shelters. Mm-hmm. This model has been implemented in Delhi and we are finding it very effective. So these approaches can be taken.
Now, you talked of social issues in Rajasthan.
Yes.
There's a very skewed sex ratio.
Yes.
What is being done to look into this problem?
Ma'am, as per the 2011 census, the sex ratio of Rajasthan is 9.28 and child sex ratio is 8.18. To reverse this skewed sex ratio, the government is taking many measures. First of all, central government is implementing schemes like Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao.
So what is under the Beti Bachao? What is being done?
Ma'am, the major focus, impetus on the Beti Bachao Beti Padhao front is to create awareness.
First, tell me Beti Bachao. How is Beti Bachao being looked into?
Ma'am, first, Beti
Bachao. Is there some act under this?
There is the PCPNDT.
So, is it being implemented? It's supposed to be to look into the diagnostic of a child, of the sex of a child?
Yes.
So, what is being done?
Ma'am, Rajasthan has adopted a very innovative approach to implement the PCPNDT.
Mm-hmm.
For example, women because are being employed to outburst the illegal sonography centers, etc.
Yes.
And at the other front, ma'am, awareness is being clearly very.
And for the Beti Padhao, is government doing anything?
Yes, ma'am. Beti Padhao also. Now the government has set up 200 Kasturba Gandhi Balika Vidyalayas. Then we have in the neighborhood areas, since the female literacy is very low, we have special residential schools in that area also. And apart from that, women education is being promoted by awards like Gandhi Award, then providing the bicycles, scooties after 10th, 12th class, etc. So these are all the measures.
And what is being done for the child marriage problem?
Ma'am, I do indeed believe that child marriage is a huge problem, not only in Rajasthan, but all over the country.
Yes.
And to tackle this menace, basically the government is implementing a program known as Aaja Abhiyan, which is an IEC campaign, and to promote more awareness about the harmful effects of the child marriage. Then we are focusing on proper implementation of the Right to Education Act to provide free and compulsory education to the child also. And these are some of the measures.
So, you also talked about pollution.
Yes,
that certain cities' pollution is very high. We know that Delhi has a very high level of pollution. And now the latest was that hard metals are found in air pollution. So you're a chemical engineer. Tell me, how does that happen? They say there's a large concentration of lead in both water and air pollution.
Ma'am, the first major source of lead is in petrol. Secondly, ma'am, in the industrial emissions also, these metals, trace metals, are found in the smoke of the air. So these are some of the areas from where the metals like lead, arsenic.
So what can be done to look into this problem, to overcome the problem?
First of all, we can improve our fuel quality. As we already know that government is now implementing the BS6 norms, and it will come into effect by 2000.
Why have we jumped from 4 to 6 and why not 5 in between?
And this direct jump from 4 to 6 indicates the government's commitment which it has made in the Paris Agreement. And I think this lead to BS6 will lead to much more cleaner fuels. It will directly impact the. Another thing is that the BS4 norms were implemented for a very late period, and the period was extended by a bit, and hence adequate time was also given for the companies to switch on from BS4 to BS6 engines also.
Okay.
All right.
Thank you.
Mr. Shekhawat, how do you see the working of Indian federalism? How it has evolved over the period?
Sir, I think it is progressively evolved over a period of time. We are finding much more coordination and cooperation between the states, but at the same time, we are finding some problems also. At the positive side, I can mention the Niti Aayog, which has played a primary role in bringing together central and states as possible. And secondly, sir, we are having many of the government schemes are now being adequately implemented by the state governments also. So in this field,
we are transferring more and more states, more and more schemes to states.
Finance Commission role also is very important in this. We are moving, providing more devolution to the states. And as far as issues are concerned, recently we see the CBI issue. The consent was not given. And there are some other issues also in which central and states are at loggerheads.
At the same time, we have certain features which makes the center strong.
Yes. Right? Is it strong? Yes, sir, I can list some of these. We have some of the constitutional provisions. For example, we have been provision for national emergency, we have the provision for presidential rule. And then in the concurrent list, if the central government passes any law which is in contradiction with the state law, the central law will proceed. And then we have also certain mechanisms by which the Rajya Sabha can pass a resolution.
Where do you see the role of all India services in this?
Sir, indeed, all India services have a major role. But sir, the All India Services has a role in national integration and bringing all the states together for national development.
Okay. you mentioned of cooperative federalism. What exactly is that?
Sir, cooperative federalism is a concept in which the states themselves come together to cooperate on various issues, evolve synergy for which national development takes place.
What are the instrumentalities?
For example, sir, Niti Aayog has come up with a lot of indices in which states are competing amongst each other, they are cooperating also. And then in the internal security front, we have cooperation, the police to police cooperation, for example, the Greyhounds, collaboration of Andhra Pradesh government and the Odisha government to tackle the Naxal menace. Similarly, we have the state DGP's conference, we have the chief secretary's conference also. So these all
organizations are different subjects.
Yes.
Rajasthan has done reasonably well in labor reforms.
Yes,
are you aware of?
Yes, sir, I am aware of these reforms.
Can you mention some of the initiatives taken by the government of Rajasthan?
Sir, some of the initiatives taken up. First of all, the industry which employ more than 300 workers now can have the liberty to retrench the labor from their workforce. Secondly, the threshold for the implementation of the Factories Act, it has been increased from 20 to 40. Thirdly, sir, the trade unions, the formation of trade unions, the threshold was earlier 15%, now it has increased to 30%.
Good. So what is the basic idea behind these reforms?
So the basic concept, the idea behind these reforms is to promote ease of doing business.
Okay. What is the primitive tribe? Well, now I think we call them particularly vulnerable tribal groups, PVT. How do you define that?
Sir, there are some sections among the tribal populations who are significantly backward. They still practice the primitive way of living. They still practice the old traditional occupations like steel charming, etc.
Is there a certain constitutional safeguards for which?
Yes, sir, there are certain constitutional safeguards. For example, we have the Schedule 5 and the Schedule 6 pertaining to the tribal areas as well as the scheduled areas. And, sir,
Forest Rights Act is in the news now.
Yes.
The implementation of that. Why is it in the news and how serious is the issue?
Sir, the Honorable Supreme Court has stayed its earlier judgment in which it called for the eviction of around 11.8 lakh tribals whose claims have been rejected on the forest land. And it is a very major issue because, sir, after 15 years of implementation of the Forest Rights Act in 2006, we are still having some glitches in registering the rights of tribals. Right? And the Supreme Court has ordered due process to be followed.
Okay,
thank you.
Now, you have named labor reforms in Rajasthan, right?
Yes, sir.
Name three other strengths of Rajasthan, where it has done some progress.
Sir, one area is in the infrastructure sector. Very huge amount of work is being carried out in the industry sector, especially the Bureau of Investment Promotion. It has come with a single window clearance system, and it is a very strong instrument to promote ease of doing business in the industry.
Say areas where you have achieved something, not where it is still in continuing or planned.
Sir, I would like to mention some of the areas which we have achieved substantial progress. First is the education sector. Our literacy rate was only 40%, now we have moved to near to 70% in the present times. Secondly, we have worked very well in the health sector also. The IMR and MMR also has improved to a very great extent. Thirdly, sir, we have achieved substantial progress in the agriculture sector also. Now the government has promoted what we call as agroclimatic zonation of crops. We are moving towards biofuels. Rajasthan, in fact, is the first state to implement the national biofuel policy.
What is Rajasthan's achievement in the field of wind power and solar power?
Sir, Rajasthan is a major contributor in the grid of renewable energy, especially in the terms of wind power and solar power.
How much does it, solar does it produce?
Sir, solar energy is around 5 gigawatts. I'm sorry, sir, I think it's
2300 megawatts. 5 megawatt is very much. Then wind power?
Sir, I'm not aware of the exact.
I'm not aware. Now, Indira Gandhi Canal,
yes, sir.
Where does it begin and where does it end?
Sir, it begins from the Harike Barrage of Satluj and Bees, and it ends in the Barmer district.
Which district does it traverse? Which district survives?
Sir, it traverses from Hanumangarh to Kentavas, then it moves to Sri Ganganagar, then it moves to Jaisalmer, then Bikaner, then Jaisalmer, and then Barmer.
What is the total length of it?
Sir, I'm aware.
How much area it has been able to irrigate since it was established?
Sir, I'm not aware of it.
Does Supreme Court make laws?
No, sir.
No. Does it have power to lay down decisions which have the force of law?
Yes.
Under what articles of the Constitution?
Sir, under the Article 142 of the Constitution.
141, 142.
Yes, thank you.
What is the difference between the two?
Sir, I am unaware about the Article 141. But 142 allows the Supreme Court to do absolute justice towards anything, and it can hence.
Right. How much reservation of Gujjars exists in Rajasthan?
Sir, Gujjar along with five other communities enjoy a reservation of 5% in Rajasthan.
So what is now the limit? What? How much reservation does exist in total in Rajasthan?
Sir, it is around 54%.
54%.
Yes.
So, has it been challenged in a court of law?
Sir, it has been challenged in a court of law, but a decision has not come yet.
Where, which court?
High Court? Yes, High Court. Yes.
Social justice provisions. Social justice.
Yes.
Those provisions in the Constitution which are enforceable in Part 3.
Yes, sir.
Which promote social justice? Can you identify them?
Sir, some of the provisions are the right against untouchability. And, then
that is Article?
17, sir.
Okay. What else?
Then we have the Article 15, in which we provide special measures for women, etc. Then we have the Article 23 and 24.
Yes, correct.
These are some of the articles.
Do 73, 74 amendment also provide social justice?
Yes.
In what?
Sir, in the way it provides reservation to the backward communities, the scheduled castes and scheduled tribes.
And women.
And women also, sir.
Now, you are as a chemical engineer.
Yes, sir.
Have you read the judgment on Supreme Court judgment on Novartis case, Greenback case?
Sir.
Patents?
Sir, I have not read the judgment.
But are you aware of the patents law in India?
Yes, sir.
Which chemical engineering has to keep in mind?
Sir, I'm not aware of the exact provisions.
The difference between branded drugs and generic drugs?
Yes, sir. I know, sir.
You know it?
Yes.
So, you know this case?
Sir, this case I'm not aware of. I may have read it some time back, but I'm not able to recall it, the specific judgment.
COP 21.
Yes, sir.
Now, what did it decide?
Sir, the COP21 was held in Paris, France, where the Paris Agreement was finalized. And it was decided that the countries will make efforts to stop the global warming to exceed 2 degrees Celsius, and efforts will be made to put it under 1.5 degrees Celsius.
And then, countries were also to formulate their INDCs.
Yes.
What is India's INDC?
Sir, some of the INDCs of India are, first of all, we have to reduce the emissions by 33 to 35% by 2030 from 2005 levels. Secondly, we have to build a carbon sink of 2.5 to 3 billion tons.
Of carbon dioxide, equivalent to
equal. And we have to install a renewable energy capability of 175 gigawatt by
40% of our energy production,
yes,
will be from renewables. 40%. 175 is part of it.
Yes.
How much are we producing at the moment? Electricity?
Sir, electricity? Sir, I'm not aware of
it. Yes. Okay. We close the interview.
Thank you, sir.
I'll give you a little feedback. Mostly you've done well. You've been able to handle questions nicely about Rajasthan, about INDCs. We feel that most questioning will be the way we are asking questions, that is based on your prior data.
Thank you.
You're from Rajasthan, that is one area. Public administration, so we have asked you questions about some constitutional business, lawmaking authority, etc. There are other things like basic structure concept.
Yes.
Criminals being kept away from politics, Supreme Court is taking certain measures.
Yes.
Then chemical engineering. And lastly, for interference. These are the areas where we feel you should be able to handle them. You know the major events which are taking place in international field?
Yes, sir, I am keeping it up.
Good luck.
All the best.
Good luck.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
You'll get outside.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. And press the bell icon to never miss an update.